go soon. Nick Foles, maybe next year as a backup, got a lot of money tied up in him still moving forward. As for Nagy's future, the coach addressed it.
No, I'm not. I just think that right now with our team that, you know, this is the stuff through the season that you go through. And it's about fighting adversity. It's about building cultures and staying together. Obviously, the last 5 weeks has been extremely difficult. It's not fun. And because we all want to win, and we know that.
A lot of coach speak there. I mean, it is. But he did this to himself. There's no way in hell when you're 3-0, regardless to what you feel about Mitch Trubisky as a starting quarterback, that you should have ever turned to Nick Foles. I understand you vouched for Nick Foles. You went out and got Nick Foles in a trade, and you felt like you needed to justify that by going to him, even though Mitch Trubisky had you at 3-0 at the time. 3-0. Comeback win against the Lions. You know, it wasn't Aaron Rodgers. He wasn't Drew Brees, right? He wasn't Russell Wilson. He wasn't playing at that level, but you were 3-0. There's no need to disrupt the team chemistry at that point in time. Had he all of a sudden lost two in a row and a couple turnovers in the two that you lost, now you look to Nick Foles. Because three games in a season, if you wanted to play Nick Foles, you should have started him at the beginning of the year. Just because that was your intent to begin with. And if your intent was to play Nick Foles all along, you should have did it at the beginning of the season. Why disrupt the team at 3-0?
I'm going to give myself a Keyshawn Johnson moment. A little pat on the back. Here. Can you remember after that Panthers game, everybody's
no,
like,
I don't remember. Yeah,
I remember. Everybody's like, well, the Bears, I'm telling you, they're going to be good. I'm like, all right. They're about to end up playing a lot of tough teams, and their defense, it feels like their defense was so exceptional. It was keeping them involved in ball games, but obviously they had a lot of questions with the quarterback position. Obviously now losing five in a row. Look, man, this team was never what exactly they were, Key. And it's interesting to me, Matt Nagy, all I've heard people talk about him be is a quarterback guru. Quarterback guru, right? Those are the words I heard to describe Matt Nagy. Not you, Key, but other people in our profession, experts.
That's how he got the
this
job.
This is what are you supposed to do, right? That's how he got the job. So I'm sitting there watching this quarterback expert. You know, Nick Foles gets inserted into the lineup. Questions. You're not giving your quarterback that you drafted the extra attention. It's just, it's an absolute disaster and mess.
He certainly dropped the ball on the quarterback situation. There's no question about it. And the reason that I say you don't turn to Nick Foles at 3-0 because you were winning games. And whenever you win, it's hard as hell to win games in a National Football League. You only get 16 of them. And you had three in your back pocket. Mm. So when you're looking at that, no matter how you're doing it, as ugly as the New England Patriots offense looked yesterday, guess what they did?
They won.
That's all that matters.
Covers all the flaws.
When you look at what he did going to Nick Foles, it's like, okay, Nick Foles won a game for you. All right, but you've lost five in a row now. You lost five in a row. So with a hope and a prayer, you inserted Trubisky back into the lineup when he should have never been taken out, hoping that he could maybe ignite some energy into the offense. The offense was going to be the same as it's always been. But when you let the air out of the room by benching him to begin with, people on the team, other players on the defensive side, they see that. They see them quarterbacks in practice too. And practice is the easiest thing you've ever seen in a National Football League. Well, everybody's great in practice. So I'm sure Nick Foles was spitting that thing out and it was hitting on everybody's in their hands and it was perfect. But then when you go to the games, you know who Nick Foles is. Nick Foles is a quarterback that can hold it down for a couple games and that's it. He's that manageable guy for two or three games, get you over the hump if somebody gets hurt. But he's not the guy who you say, well, I'm benching Jay Will. I'm going to Nick Foles because he's better.
Key, one of my friends that played AAU ball with, his mom would always say this when she saw somebody really tall who didn't play basketball. She'd be like, oh, you're kind of a waste of tall.
No, right? big for no reason.
Right? A waste of tall, right? That's what I want to say about their defense. That's a waste of a great defense. I mean, granted, their defense is getting beaten down over this period of time. But if you had a serviceable quarterback, I mean, they could find themselves serviceable quarterback. You could find yourselves potentially in a wild card opportunity and a Super Bowl opportunity.
No matter how great the defenses are in these leagues, if they're on the field after straight three and outs and five and outs and interceptions,
yeah,
they're going to be deflated. Exactly. I mean, that's just what it is. If you think about how Chicago made it to the Super Bowl under Lovie Smith, the defense was lights out, and they had a serviceable guy in Rex Grossman. I said Rex Ryan. Rex Grossman, serviceable guy.
Seemingly always been the plan in Chicago,
that's
right?
That's the great plan defense, in Chicago.
That's their DNA.
So why all of a sudden do you have to go to Nick Foles when the guy you had in Mitch Trubisky was just this serviceable guy? Goes back to justification. We went up to grab him at number two. We have to now try to justify who he is as a quarterback, so we're going to throw the ball all over the lot. No, just hand the ball off, run the ball, dink and dunk, and let your defense win the game.
Pull a Baker Mayfield.
Let me ask both of you guys this question, because you guys have been through the ringer of a season, a couple seasons. Quick thing for Mitch Trubisky. Next up is the Lions. The Lions are in turmoil. If there is one team, believe it or not, that Trubisky has actually played great against in his career.
Lions!
Dominated the Lions. I'm not sure what that means. Probably means nothing. But they are next. So if the Bears want to try to snap that five-game losing streak, it's actually the one opponent of the other 31 that Trubisky certainly wants to see. Help me understand this, whether it's basketball or football. On January 6th, 2019, so just about 2 years ago, less than 2 years ago, all right, January 6, 2019, the Bears lost a playoff game to the Eagles on the infamous double doink field goal. You might remember that, essentially, where boom, boom, Bears had the hit at the upright, hit the crossbar, didn't go through, and their season was shot. But the future was bright. Trubisky had gotten them through enough. They had this hot young coach. They had Khalil Mack, as Jay's referenced, the Bears' defense. Don't worry about it. It's the first time we made the playoffs, I believe, in about 8 years. They've not made the playoffs in 8 years at that point. Things are looking up with the QB position. He'll get better because we got a QB whisperer, as Jay said, with Matt Nagy, and we got Khalil Mack. In less than 2 years, the building has imploded. Mm-hmm. How does that happen in less than 2 years?
Because you go from January to September. That's a long time, right? That's a long time from January to September.
The offseason.
So, the offseason. So now you want to be smart and bright. And, oh, I could do this with him and I could do that. And just do what you did that got you there the first time around. Sure. You don't need to reinvent the damn wheel.
Right.
You know, oh, it's boring. These coaches are boring. They do the same things over and over. Yeah, Sean Payton wins a lot of games doing the same thing over and over. Bill Belichick wins a lot of games doing the same thing over and over. Bill Parcells, yes, he's stuck in the Stone Ages. He won a lot of games doing everything over and over.
Sure.
Just do the same thing that got you there. Why all of a sudden do you have to justify the number two pick because I'm an offensive so-called guru, expert, quarterback guy?